of State for Home Affairs, to join us today for this very important session on Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, Opportunities for Homeland Security Industry. Minister has been very busy, but it is a very kind of you, Honorable Sir, to join us today. And to formally welcome you, I request President Fiki, Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, to deliver her welcome address. Madam, over to you.
Dear Shri Kishan Reddy Garu, Honorable Minister of State for Home Affairs, Government of India, namaste and a very warm welcome. Siddharth Jain, Director Narendra Explosives, Mukesh Sharma, Rahul Chaudhary, Akshay Singhal, industry colleagues, representative of the police forces, Secretary General, and all other members from FICCI, namaste and a very good morning to all of you. I'm genuinely delighted to welcome Honorable Minister Shri Kishan Reddy and thank him for taking time from his busy schedule to join us. We will, besides a range of other things, discuss how India's homeland security industry could be made self-reliant at a time when the Honorable Prime Minister has given a clarion call for Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. And I think this is a significant initiative and the entire country is echoing this call. It is quite evident all around us, even the format of this meeting, that the world is experiencing an unprecedented crisis. And this is disrupting the global economy. While a significant package has been announced, which is a combination of fiscal and non-fiscal measures and a lot of policy initiatives, we need to find multiple ways to help India recover from the severe economic crisis which has been faced because of the pandemic. In addition to the economic package announced, the call to a self-reliant India is not just about import substitution and is definitely not about isolationism. The emphasis is really on active participation in the global supply chain, on attracting foreign direct investment, while at the same time encouraging industrial manufacturing, indigenous manufacturing, encouraging international partners to find the strength of India and use India as a base. The idea is resilience, flexibility, attractiveness, competitiveness of the Indian capabilities, allowing the Indian economy to adapt to the challenges and the opportunities post-COVID. In the past, India has not sufficiently tapped its capability on self-reliance. And going forward, I think the strategy of celebrating made in local is going to be a significant part, but also most importantly is to use the strengths of Indian capability, our engineering, our IT, our sincere and very capable working class, and put that into a policy framework which encourages international businesses to find India as an appropriate base, while our own focus on innovation, research, and capability grows Indian business. The ecosystem of homeland security has two main pillars, mainly manufacturing and research and development. The government has launched the Made in India concept to place India as a manufacturing hub. And there's also a significant focus on research and R&D. To emerge as a reliable supply chain to the state police forces, to the central armed police forces, the industry must be willing to invest in R&D, but also in very close interaction with the ultimate users. And this meeting is one such, where we put forth the capabilities of Indian industry and present it to the government, to the armed forces, to the police forces, and say that we are ready to appreciate and understand the unique needs that you have and innovate and research to create products which are India-centric, user-friendly, and will enhance the role that this very, very important part of the society and the Indian armamentarium does. I would also like to state that FICCI will be very happy to work with the MHA and facilitate the industry in this regard. I believe that there is a market maker role for the MHA in the support of the Atmanirbhar package. And there is work to be done in terms of price variations linked to inflation indices, WPI, CPI, to be there is a need to allow a stable domestic supply chain, which is crucial for exports. And many of these, I won't go into detail, but I'm sure it will be discussed. But the domestic supply chain, which impacts both the MSME, the medium, and the large industries, we must focus on these. We request the MHA to list all facilities and issues so that we can productively and proactively address these. And appreciate also how we create central and shared testing facility so that our own indigenous capability gets enhanced. My last point, I think, that towards the goal of self-reliance in the internal security sector, increasing efforts made towards indigenization, wherever technologically feasible and economically viable, are very possible. The Indian private sector is keen to support the requirements of the CAPF, the police force, and contribute towards Make in India. FICCI looks forward to playing an active role with the ministry. Once again, we not just welcome you for this initiative, sir, but thank you for the tremendous work that the ministry has done in implementing so much self-discipline at it, and law and order, the entire safety of the scenario, at a time when the world is showing that, you know, civil unrest can be quite devastating. And I think the police force all over the country have played a tremendous role. So I want to end by welcoming you, laying out the role and the excitement of the industry, and thanking the ministry and the police services across the country for their great and proactive role during this crisis. Namaste, and thank you all very much.
Thank you, Madam President, for your follow-up. Honorable Minister, FICCI along with ENY has come out with a report, a joint report on Atmanirbhar Bharat opportunities for homeland security industry. And it's indeed a pleasure that you have kindly consented to launch that report. So may I request you to kindly release the report? And request the host to share the screen, please. Thank you so much, Honorable Minister. This is the report which FICCI has come out with in partnership with ENY. And going forward, I'll request our partner ENY, Akshay Singhal, partner from ENY, to very briefly mention about the white paper which we have done along with them. Over to you, Akshay.
Thank you, Sumit. So good morning, all. I'm sure you must have traveled long distances to reach the FICCI auditorium to attend this seminar and the workshop. I would have said so in a regular scenario when addressing a FICCI auditorium, but I think now things are different, so are the ways in which we interact with each other. So I hope you all are sound and safe in your offices and in your homes. So welcome all. Regarding the whole concept about Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, and I believe that this Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, it is just not a scheme for the from the government today to kickstart a few things. It is also not just a temporary initiative by the government of India in this pandemic crisis. I believe Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan is a way of life. It's a way of life because we all need to now work towards changing the way in which the world looks at India, in which India looks at India and its resources now, and how we can make Atmanirbhar Abhiyan successful by bringing in appropriate initiatives which are India focused and that make India self-reliant. And Honorable Minister and Ma'am Sunita Reddy, Ma'am, have said, introduced the whole topic about how important it is for all of us to start focusing inwards and making a lot of initiatives which can support the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan and make it the regular way of life for us going forward. Now, picking up various pillars and the five I's of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, I would like to focus only on two for the purpose of homeland security. One is around inclusion and the other is around innovation. Inclusion is a concept where we, to make this initiative more successful, it is important to have participation from the industry at all levels, in all decision making of the government. And one of the finest example that the government of India took in 2018 is when Niti Aayog came up its first paper around AI that got released in 2018 in deep consultation with the industry. And the impact of that white paper in consultation with the industry is that today every digital project, every digital transformation project that comes out as a tender or as an innovation concept has AI built in it. And that's because there was a strong participation from the industry and there was strong inclusion. The second aspect around this is the innovation, which going forward, India needs to also move away from being a assembly line of manufacturing to something where an R&D is set up in India, where an R&D focus is established in India by both the Indian industries, the MSMEs, the medium, large, bigger industries as well, and also the foreign players. Intent is to move purely from assembly line and putting nuts and bolts together in our manufacturing plants to start maybe taking a step backward and do an R&D, create our own products and solutions and take them forward. So I believe from this particular slide that you see, we focus on the two key pillars of I, which are inclusion and innovation. If I go forward, you see this slide deck, which talks about key statistics from the security industry. Today, which is also a good comfort among us, is 30% of the MSME in India is based out of security industry itself. Now, security industry has a vast array of solutions, devices, equipments, arms and ammunition that it manufactures today in the country. And idea is to increase this 30% wallet of security industry to 70, 80, 90, as much as possible from India industry perspective. You would see a $3.9 billion strategic investment in the strategic electronic sector as well. Now, this is something which is happening within India. And when I say strategic electronic sector, it encompasses anything to do with the defense and defense related equipment and productions. Now, this is a big push and jump that we already see. But on the right hand side, you see another statistic which talk about $2.8 billion of imports that we do in security industry every year, which itself means there is a lot of scope for us, for the Indian industries, to pick that piece of pie from 2.8 billion and manufacture that in India and become more and more self-reliant. The pie chart that you see here on the left hand side bottom, it talks about how that 30% is broken down within the Indian MSMEs as well. So you see a large portion of the game in the industry, security industry, is played by the micro industries, then the medium and the small. It means that these micro industries have strength, innovation ability, and a zeal to create newer solutions for Indian market and make them implemented at all levels. And then you also see that Ministry of Home Affairs has also been constantly focusing on increasing its own budget year on year. You see a CAGR of about 12%. Today we're talking about a 1 lakh crore of budget that is allocated by Home Ministry in terms of its security aspects as well. So there has been significant push year on year by the ministry to strengthen the spend and building the capability in the security industry as well. So this statistics in total gives us at one point in time the relief that we are 30% of the overall industry, MSME industry in the country, and also give us an opportunity to look at how we reduce the import here and become more and more self-sufficient by establishing more industries within the country. Moving ahead, this slide talks about the overall ecosystem, wherein you have all the players from law enforcement agencies to disaster management agencies to critical infrastructure agencies, private security agencies, smart cities, safe cities, all these together make the sector here today. So the user base is huge. The idea is how we can create newer solutions to cater to the needs of this user base. And then you see the various stakeholders are used, from system integrators, consultants, to manufacturing companies, to telecom service providers, who play a role as a stakeholder in this ecosystem. One thing that I want to highlight around here is the role of standards agencies, certification agencies, and the regulatory bodies. Because the moment we start a push around manufacturing in India, developing in India, innovating in India, it is important that our certification and standardization agencies and our regulatory bodies are also geared up to accept the new parameters, to accept the new innovative solutions and start making policies catering to them as well. So this is an important stakeholder in our ecosystem. And on the bottom, you see the array of solutions, the array of products that can be manufactured within the country. A lot of them is being, but a lot of them is also being imported today. How we can strengthen the MSME players and how we can incentivize the foreign players also to start setting up R&D centers in India and start setting up pure manufacturing centers in India as well. But we today are looking out of the country to our imports, various European and North American countries as well. Idea is to now become look more inward and create everything internally. The next slide. And this is the last slide for now, where we talk about few critical things that we need to look at. One important point, which is point number four, I want to highlight is on the standardization of product requirements. It is important that when we are moving in the path of being self-reliant, we redefine our quality control processes. We pick up the global practices as well. And then we encourage our own units to adhere to these global practices, to adhere to these quality control practices, so that all these become standardized. It becomes easy for standardization and certification agencies like BIS or others to come out with policies and guidelines accordingly, and the implementation of the MSME power is much easier. The second point I want to highlight is point number six here, which is the long-term sustenance. We can keep talking about setting up R&D centers in India by both the MSME industry and the foreign players, but the idea is how do you make this thing long-term sustainable? And largely the focus should be around creation of more and more IPR, creation of more and more patents within the country, so that we control them and then we monetize them and we start manufacturing things which we cannot take out of the country as well. So we become a global player after having had fulfilled our own internal demands too. And this move to global industry scenario can happen when we standardize a lot of these quality control and certification processes, and when we have a well-defined concept of IPR and the patents established within our industry. So I think with this, I pause now and I request Mr. Tegel. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you, Akshay, for sharing your perspective and talking about the paper which we have come out together with. And Honorable Minister, going forward, we have two of our members who will be talking about they are the indigenous manufacturers within the country, and they'll be talking about their experiences, perspective, opportunities, and of course, highlighting some of the challenges as well. So, but in interest of time, I request the members to be very brief and to the point, please. So the first, I invite Mr. Mukesh Sharma, the director of RK & Sons, to very briefly share his perspective. Mr. Sharma.
Good morning. Dear Shri Krishna Reddy, Honorable Home Minister, Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, Mr. Rahul Chaudhary, Siddharth Jain, and Mr. Sumit Gupta. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to raise certain questions or concerns on this platform. First of all, thank you, Fiki, for giving me this opportunity to raise the concerns. As we all are aware, the manufacturing landscape is evolving rapidly. The prioritization of indigenized manufacturing in current Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan will definitely help set up the tone for expanded domestic capacities and larger investments in production capabilities. However, the MSME ecosystem remains underdeveloped for a variety of reasons. I strongly believe that the recent announcement by the Ministry of Finance under Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan for disallowing the global tenders up to 200 crores to support and encourage MSME companies is a positive step towards self-reliant India. I would like to use this forum to highlight the issues faced by MSMEs have capability to manufacture state-of-art security equipments under Made in India program. I repeat, under Made in India program, not Make in India. These companies are also exporting to the global markets. The capable MSMEs face shortage of technical raw materials, and availability of substandard and cheap Chinese raw material. It may be noted that when a manufacturer or an entrepreneur initiates the design of a solution, the first thing that is required is the raw material. However, for example, everybody talks about bulletproof jackets, but the cost difference between a renowned, or for example, a company like DuPont manufactured Kevlar is worth around 20,000 to 30,000 rupees per kg. And it becomes absolutely economically unviable as the Chinese raw material is available for a throwaway price. But when we compare the product, the end product between the two raw materials, the Chinese material has a shelf life of less than a year, whereas DuPont can go up to 5 to 6 years. On behalf of all the MSMEs, I hereby request the Honorable Home Minister to clearly define the raw material specifications to keep the cheap and substandard products away from being inducted by our security forces. Another important challenge that is faced by MSME is the infrastructure for testing facility. The government should encourage private participation for setting up internationally accredited laboratories to compete against other manufacturers on global platform. Hence, requirement for testing facilities and infrastructure needs to be developed. Be it personal ballistic protection equipments or electronics testing capability. We are currently dependent on a few laboratories overseas, which can be negated if the existing government-owned laboratories or the NABL laboratories are upgraded to the global testing standards. This capability enhancement will not only encourage a product development, but by having these testing facilities in-house can also reduce or encourage the MSMEs to use the right raw material while they are designing a end solution. It is a known fact that to develop or to reverse engineer any product, substantial amount of money is required. As the local market for homeland security looks very promising, but there is no mechanism wherein research and development programs are run while the production is ongoing. One of the reasons R&D is not preferred is due to the cost involved. The government, through Ministry of Home Affairs, should consider establishing a dedicated R&D program by identifying the requirement of equipments, that is, to the annual imports, which in case of being successful can easily reduce the import cost and the foreign exchange to zero. The technology developed can be owned by the Ministry of Home Affairs and may be sold commercially on exclusive or sharing basis to maintain competition in the industry. Most of the companies which are working in the homeland security industry are traders, agents, representatives of international companies. By encouraging R&D, these small players can be encouraged for turning into entrepreneurs, since every company or individual that deals in this industry has a rich experience of more than 15 to 20 years of expertise. So the subject knowledge is a good asset for, as on date, for the homeland security. In order to achieve self-reliant and to become made in India, we must emphasize on the raw material quality, latest machineries, and in-house test facility and R&D. As MSMEs, there are other hurdles also that are faced while the equipment manufactured is offered to the government departments. There is no cooperation from the government departments for giving inputs or the expectations for the performance of equipment. It has been experienced on many occasions that the Made in India product is outrightly rejected by the technical evaluation committee, which they compare the product produced in India with the international available product. In absence of clear communication or interaction with the end users, the entire efforts for developing and manufacturing equipment goes waste. I would humbly like to submit that the Honorable Government should direct the end users to organize workshops, idea exchange programs for enabling the MSMEs to develop the required solution by them. I very strongly feel that the country which can develop nuclear bombs or create world-class satellites can surely develop security products such as handheld ground-penetrating radars, bomb suits, anti-mine boots, non-linear junction detectors, etc. For our jawans, if we are able to identify a list of priority security equipments that should be developed, we can easily and definitely develop them. And we, as we all are aware, during this pandemic, we have successfully developed the PPE kits or face masks, which were required largely. Further, as I had mentioned earlier, there should be a mechanism or a system wherein the research laboratories like DRDO, Ordnance Factory Boards, Army Base Workshops may allow the MSMEs to jointly or independently work on developing an equipment or solution. And a healthy environment should be created to work as a team. The mission collectively should become self-reliant and made in India product. The government has announced a financial aid to MSMEs, but no such benefits are passed by the bankers to the MSMEs, SSIs, individual entrepreneurs. Likewise, the Ministry of Home Affairs or local enforcement agencies may introduce a monetary fund to help.
Mr. Sharma, I'm sorry to intervene. Actually, in interest of time, Minister has a limited time and he has to leave.
This is a very important point regarding the financial aid to MSMEs. I humbly request that the government department should consider a minimum advance payment of 30% to the MSMEs or to the micro manufacturer. This can be of a great help to everyone. Lastly, I'm really grateful to all of you for listening to me. Thank you. And I'm very confident that together we can realize the vision of Honorable Prime Minister of India as self-reliant India. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Sharma. Now I request Mr. Jain. I request Mr. Jain to please be very brief and just to be to the point and raise one or two points which you really want to highlight. Mr. Jain.
A very good morning to the Honorable Minister of State, Home Affairs, Mr. Gopal Kishan Reddy, and other dignitaries attending this webinar on Atmanirbhar Bharat, opportunities for homeland security. At the outset, I wish to thank FICCI for organizing this webinar and for giving me an opportunity to express our views on today's subject on homeland security. Allow me to introduce myself as Siddharth Jain, Director of Narendra Explosives Limited, based in Dehradun in the state of Uttarakhand. Having our manufacturing facilities with DRDO as our partners to manufacture oleoresin capsaicin based tear smoke products, namely tear smoke shells, tear smoke grenades, and tear gas launchers. The speciality of these products is that firstly, they are based on a new and latest technology developed by DRDO, and secondly, oleoresin, a herbal product, which is very effective and does not cause any permanent damage or harm to a human body and is most effective for mob control and anti-riot purposes in miscreants. The unique feature of oleoresin grenade is that it does not require any kind of explosive or ammunition to initiate and is thus very safe to use by our police forces. After having made huge investments in setting up manufacturing facilities, creating land and buildings, licenses, permissions from all concerned departments, setting up plant and machinery and licenses from technology from DRDO, we have failed against the monopolistic pattern of the government purchase policy system, despite our running from pillar to post. I wish to draw attention to the following challenges faced by us in order to market our DRDO-approved tear smoke munitions. Preference to government factories like Tear Smoke Unit and OFB hampers the growth and survival of our MSME unit. Even after having QOT partnership with DRDO for commercialization of Tear Smoke products, we do not get level playing field at par with TSU-BSF for supply of these products to central and state forces like CRPF and state police forces. TSMs produced by us are of the same technology, quality as being manufactured by Tear Smoke Unit, even though we are less priced. Central and state police forces should be allowed to procure their requirements of tear smoke munitions from open market by floating tender or through GEM portal, as is being practiced by them for other stores, arms and ammunition, in order to assess better quality, competitive price and timely deliveries. Generic specifications for the same is to be drawn. Instead of placing consolidated annual demand of tear smoke munitions of all central and state forces to Tear Smoke Unit BSF through BPR&D, the same should be procured through tender or GEM as per requirement of the forces. Necessary guidelines are required to be issued to BPR&D for issuance of their recommendation and certification to the DRDO developed products, as same is required by central and state forces when being commercialized by DRDO TOT holders. If any new product is acceptable by central and state police forces after its evaluation during the course of NCNC trials, process for its authorization in the forces should be initiated expeditiously in order to get the forces modernized as per the need of the hour. Since MSME is the biggest sector in generating employment, hence allowing above regulations will help to groom and will definitely meet the biggest challenge of unemployment in the country. It is also suggested that the government may enlist private vendors like us, who are DRDO TOT holders, as an approved and acceptable exporter of tear smoke products outside India under the government scheme of grant and aid to other countries through MOD, MEA and MHA. Apart from the above challenges, due to the ongoing pandemic of COVID-19 across the country, following issues were also raised. A huge amount of fund towards police modernization and upgradation has been put on hold by the central and state police forces for the ongoing pandemic across the world. Due to the ongoing COVID-19 lockdown and restrictions in interstate movement, the state police forces are not able to conduct demonstrations for various new technologies. In this scenario, we suggest that the forces may be issued guidelines to accept samples from the industry to conduct demonstrations themselves on NCNC basis.
Mr. Jain, sorry to interrupt. Mr. Jain, in the interest of time, could I request you to conclude, please?
It is my last point now. Lastly, I would like to take an example of our sister concern, Mrs. Dynex India, Dehradun, who are manufacturers of 12-bore arms and ammunition in Dehradun since last 60 years. And their manufacturing license is with the Ministry of Home Affairs for conversion from Form 9 to Form 7 as per new arms rules 2016. Due to COVID-19, the delay has been increased inevitably. Therefore, work operations in the factory are not being resumed to the fullest. Further, 12-bore guns being produced by us are to be sent to DG Quay for the purpose of proof testing, and due to pendency from MHA, for conversion of license on Form 7, the guns cannot be get proof tested.
Okay.
I would like to make a detailed presentation with the list of challenges being faced by our industry, for which I would like to request Honorable Minister of State for Home to give us an appointment confirming any date and time convenient to him.
Thank you, Siddharth. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Siddharth. Going forward, may I request the Honorable Minister to deliver his keynote address. Over to you, sir.
सबको धन्यवाद. बहुत बड़ी अच्छी विषय है. फिक्की नेतृत्व में आज आत्मनिर्भर भारत अपॉर्चुनिटीज ऑफ होमलैंड सिक्योरिटी के बारे में आज चर्चा हो रही है. इस संदर्भ में मैं आदरणीय डॉक्टर संगीता रेड्डी गारु प्रेसिडेंट फिक्की, मिस्टर अक्षय सिंघाल गारु, मिस्टर मुकेश शर्मा गारु, मिस्टर सिद्धार्थ जैन, मिस्टर राहुल चतुर्दी, मेंबर्स ऑफ फिक्की, बहुत अच्छे विषय बताए. डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम कोट अथर्ववेद विच अवर हॉनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर Sri Narendra Modi ji quoted in his address to the nation, that is, Krutam me dakshin hesti, jayam me savya haitam, which means, I have my self effort in my left hand and victory in my right hand. This should be serve a guiding principle for all of us, that irrespective of circumstances, we find ourselves in constant effort to self-reliance will always lead us to success. This is something we have learned with the onslaught of COVID-19. It has reinforced the importance of Atmanirbharata, importance of Make in India, and the idea that India will not only raise from the crisis, but also lead the way from world community. Today, it gives me immense pleasure to see that the industry has already set itself in action to explore opportunities for gaining Atmanirbharata in the security sector. I congratulate FICCI for the organizing this important event. I also congratulate the young EY for the partnering with FICCI and releasing a report, Atmanirbharata Bharat Opportunities for Homeland Security. One of the best report I saw that. This is no denying to that fact that model of economic development practiced across the world has failed to come to grip with the uncertainty and unwillingness created by the COVID pandemic 19. Today, as we stand on the another great change, I have to strong conviction that Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji mantra of vocal for local, local to global will act as a lighthouse for the coming times. With this determination and resolve, India as a country has to move together on Prime Minister says. India will definitely get it through back, it growth back, it definitely achieve towards five things are utmost important to make India a self-reliant economy: intent, inclusion, investment, infrastructure, and innovation. Our reforms are not scattered. Rather, our reforms are planned, futuristic. Our government considers the private sector as an important partner of the government and its path of the self-reliant India. The Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan must become a people's movement with witness transformative changes in every sector. It is indeed an opportunity to lift our MSMEs sector and build the momentum and existing schemes and initiatives such as a Make in India and Easy of Doing Business. Much needed financial inputs has been provided to the sector through the 3 lakh crore collateral free automatic loans, equity support of 20,000 crores subordinate debit for the trusted MSMEs, and addition that rupees 50,000 crores equity infusion through MSME fund of funds. These measures provide much needed trust, and we need to leverage to enhance the role of MSME sector in the security domain. Promoting Atmanirbharta in the security and strategic manufacturing sector also prepares our manpower and equips our youth and next generation skills. I am pleased to share with you, recently I chaired our department MHA Modernization Division, a meeting on facilitating procurement of arms and ammunition of Central Army Police Force like CRPF, CASF, BSF, ITBP, Assam Rifle, National Security Guards, other SSB, to domestic private manufacturers, which was also attended by FICCI also. I emphasized that there is a need for a private sector to compete in price and quality in production, and it should not only cater to the domestic needs but also able to export their products. Then only this Atmanirbhar Bharat we will achieve. While the Atmanirbhar Bharat package has indeed strengthened our resolve, the government is committed towards it from very beginning. To mention some of the initiatives, Mission Raksha Jnana Shakti was launched in enable to fulfill utilization of new ideas, innovations towards achieving self-reliance. Defense sector further innovation of defense excellency was launched to the poster to ecosystem of innovation and technology. Friends, Atmanirbharta is not just a prize. It is not just a dream. It is a well thought of roadmap for the future ready India to ensure that we are well on our way. We will have to strengthen our presence in many fronts, establishing a strong public-private partnership culture. Continuing our efforts towards enhancing ease of doing business and ensuring quality and setting benchmarks. Last but not least, determination of every Indian to be part of self-reliant India. Determination, dedication, devotion, discipline, we should go. मैं सबसे पहले धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ अच्छे आत्मनिर्भरता विषय पर अपॉर्चुनिटीज होमलैंड सिक्योरिटी इंडस्ट्रीज के बारे में अच्छे रिपोर्ट आप लोग बनाए मैं बताना चाहता हूँ अभी तक तो हम ओएबी के ऊपर डिपेंड करके लगातार 70 साल से हम आमनेशन इक्विपमेंट कर प्रोक्यूरमेंट करते थे 90% आमनेशन हम ओएबी के साथ लेते थे अभी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने तय किया है आने वाले दिन में लोकल इंडस्ट्रीज से लेना चाहिए इंपोर्टेड खरीदना नहीं चाहिए उसके साथ साथ जो ओएबी के कारण बहुत कुछ प्रोडक्ट्स लेट मिलता है आमनेशन हो आर्म्स हो समय पे नहीं मिलता है इसी दृष्टि से मैं आप लोगों से अनुरोध करना चाहता हूँ जितना हो सकता है आप पूरा प्रयास करके प्रोडक्शन में आगे आना चाहिए क्योंकि अभी भारत सरकार भी तय किया है, अदने नरेंद्र मोदी जी अपील किया है, इवन डिफेंस को भी हम मेक इन इंडिया के द्वारा इक्विपमेंट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग भारत में करने का तय किया है। इसी दृष्टिकोण से मैं आप लोगों से अनुरोध करता हूं, अभी पहले जो भी प्रॉब्लम था उस प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करने के लिए भारत सरकार तय किया है। अभी एज पर दी एमएचए ऑर्डर डेटेड 2/1/2018 ऑल डीजीस ऑफ सीएपीएफ हैव बीन डेलीगेटेड फाइनेंशियल पावर्स प्रोक्योरमेंट आर्म्स एंड नॉमिनेशन अप टू 20 crores of each case, and also has been delegated financial powers to procurement new technology equipment, weapons, ammunitions for trial purpose up to 2 crores in each case. ऐसे हम थोड़ा changes भी लाए, इसके कारण से थोड़ा research and development activity भी बढ़ता है। अभी टेस्टिंग के बारे में भी बात किया है, भारत सरकार के द्वारा मैं आप लोगों को विश्वास दिलाना चाहता हूं, अलग अलग जगह हमारा टेस्टिंग सेंटर्स है, अभी टेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी भी लैबोरेटरीज भी अपग्रेडिंग के बारे में भी बताया गया है, आने वाले दिन में उस अपग्रेडिंग करेंगे, जम पोर्टल के द्वारा भी कैसा खरीदना चाहिए। अभी मैं आप लोगों को और एक बात बताना चाहता हूं, पूरे स्टेट पुलिस का भी नहीं तो सेंट्रल पुलिस का पैरामिलिट्री के ऊपर मिलिट्री के ऊपर डिपेंड नहीं होना चाहिए, उसमें लगभग 60% आप एक्सपोर्ट का भी ओरिएंटेड प्रोडक्शन भारत में जो भी इंडस्ट्रीज आम आम नेशंस में सिक्योरिटी एंगल सिक्योरिटी इक्विपमेंट में उसमें भी ध्यान देना चाहिए, एक्सपोर्ट्स होना चाहिए, एक्सपोर्ट के साथ साथ लोकल रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ स्टेट पुलिस, लोकल रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दी पैरामिलिट्री, लोकल रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दी आर्मी फोर्सेस, इसका भी आप लोग ध्यान देना चाहिए। इसलिए मैं आप लोग बताना चाहता हूं, एक्सपोर्ट ओरिएंटेड क्वालिटी भी देखना चाहिए, क्वांटिटेटिव भी प्राइस होना चाहिए, इस दृष्टिकोण से भी आगे आइए। कभी भी अभी सिद्धार्थ जी बता रहे थे अपॉइंटमेंट के बारे में, कभी भी आप आ सकते हैं, अभी हम थोड़ा डिस्कशन पहला मीटिंग हम किया है, लोकल इंडस्ट्रीज को एंकरेजमेंट करने के लिए अभी मीटिंग हुआ है, उसमें फिक्की को भी अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को इन्वॉल्व किए हैं, जो कंपनी हमारा साथ लाइसेंसेस लिए हैं वो कंपनीज को बुलाया हम ऑनलाइन में, उस कंपनी से भी व्यक्तिगत मैं स्वयं मैं भी बात किया हूं, उनसे अलग अलग कंपनीज का बात किया हूं, उनका प्रॉब्लम्स क्या है बात किया हूं, आने वाले दिन में वो समस्या दूर करेंगे, मगर आप लोग सब मिलके एक आत्मनिर्भर भारत के अंदर एक मेक इन इंडिया के द्वारा जितना भी भारत का रिक्वायरमेंट है वो रिक्वायरमेंट पूरा करने के लिए मैं आप लोगों का सहयोग चाहता हूं, आप लोग आगे आइए, जो भी प्रॉब्लम है टेबल के ऊपर बैठ के वो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करेंगे, क्योंकि आदरणीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी का यही इच्छा है लोकल प्रोडक्शन होना चाहिए। आप ही नहीं, आने वाले दिन में जितने भी डिफेंस का इक्विपमेंट है भारत में उसका प्रोडक्शन होना चाहिए, उसके लिए भी आप लोगों से भी स्वयं फिक्की से भी आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी स्वयं बहुत बार बात कर चुके हैं, आने वाले दिन में इस एक्शन के नाते एक्शन फॉर्म के नाते उसको कन्वर्ट होना चाहिए वो डिस्कशन, नाउ शुड कन्वर्ट दी एक्शन प्लान एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन पार्ट भी भारत सरकार आपके साथ देंगे। हम ये चाहते हैं ये आज जो सिक्योरिटी टेररिज्म के खिलाफ हो, इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी हो, जो एक्सटर्नल सिक्योरिटी हो, आप देखने के बाद जो रिक्वायरमेंट है वो रिक्वायरमेंट के बारे में आप भी आरएनडी यूनिट शुरू करिए, हमारा कुछ जो रिक्वायरमेंट है सीआरपीएफ को, जो पैरामिलिट्री को जो रिक्वायरमेंट है, आने वाले दिन में पूरे कंपनीज के साथ बातचीत करके हमारा रिक्वायरमेंट आप लोगों को बताएंगे, हमारा बजट बताएंगे, हमारा नेसेसिटी क्या है वो बताएंगे, क्या क्वालिटी चाहिए, कितना क्वांटिटी चाहिए, ये भी आप लोगों को मैं बताऊंगा, मगर आने वाले दिन में आप लोगों को यही अनुरोध करना चाहता हूं, थोड़ा क्वालिटी फॉर एक्सपोर्ट, क्वालिटी फॉर इंटरनल रिक्वायरमेंट देखना चाहिए इसी दृष्टिकोण से, क्योंकि अभी अभी बता रहे थे जो टेस्टिंग में पूरा रिजेक्शन हो रहे, आने वाले दिन में रिजेक्शन ना होना चाहिए, ये एंगल से पहले से ही प्रोडक्शन से पहले रिक्वायरमेंट से पहले एमएचए के क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है, स्टेट पुलिस का क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है, क्या क्वालिटी चाहिए, डिफेंस फोर्सेस को क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है, क्या क्वालिटी चाहिए, ये चर्चा करके उसी क्वालिटी के आधार पर उसका रिक्वायरमेंट के आधार पर आप प्रोडक्शन बनाइए, जरूर हम आपके साथ रहेंगे। मैं फिर एक बार आप सब लोगों को धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ। आई वंस अगेन थैंक यू फॉर ऑल योर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशंस एंड ब्रिंगिंग इंपॉर्टेंट आइडियाज एंड सजेशंस ऑन द टेबल। जय हिंद भारत माता।
Thank you, Honorable Minister. That indeed was very, very encouraging. And on behalf of industry, we assure you, PIKI assures you of all possible cooperation to make this vision of Honorable Prime Minister happen, of Make in India in overall and specifically in Homeland Security. And we'll just seek 2 more minutes of yours, Honorable Minister. I'll request the Chairman of PIKI Homeland Security, Mr. Rahul Chaudhary, to propose vote of thanks.
థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ అండి. చాలా సంతోషం మీరు మాతో మాట్లాడింది. వచ్చే కాలంలో కూడా మేము మీతో చర్చ చేసుకుంటాం. చాలా సంతోషం.
థ్యాంక్ యూ. ఇప్పుడు నాకు డిపిఆర్ఎన్జీ మీటింగ్ ఉంది.
అవునండి, థ్యాంక్ యూ.
నెక్స్ట్ అదే ఉన్నది, ఇప్పుడు రివ్యూ చేస్తున్నాం డిపిఆర్ఎన్జీది. మా డివిజన్ రివ్యూ ఉన్నది 11 o'clock అట్ ఆఫీస్ సౌత్ నార్త్ బ్లాక్.
Mr. J. Kishan Reddy, Honorable Minister for, Minister of Home, Government of India, Dr. Sangeeta Reddy. We are meeting after the Prime Minister's clarion call of taking this COVID-19 issue from being a threat to an opportunity. And that will only happen if we are prepared to move forward and change our way of working. And we are very encouraged, sir, that you have talked about bringing in reforms and start to open up the industry, open up the MHA procurement for the industry. I request just one thing from top down, which is to take a market maker role and make it official on your side. What you are saying, sir, equipment, reforms of buying from the private sector industry, a level playing field with OFB and others, unless and until there is a theoretical construct of policy on the top of it, it will not happen on the ground, because everybody in your department is working based on its own rules and regulations. So a policy change has to happen, and you need to lead that by calling it a market maker role for you, for yourself as Ministry of Home Affairs, the policies, and that will percolate. That will create the opening up and the necessary cover required for the officials who want to give us the opportunity, but unfortunately under the rules find it very difficult. So that's my request, sir. Please officially take a market maker role, and we are willing to work with you and define this as much as possible and work with your officers and get it done. But that will make huge difference. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us and encouraging us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Sangeeta garu, bayaler thanadi.
Thanks, Andy. Chala thanks. Namaste.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Minister.
Thank you, all of you. Good luck. Let's do a good follow-up on this. I think it's an important area. All the best.
Thank you. Thanks for joining.
Thank you very much, Amit and team. Thank you.